Hello, assalamu alaikum. In this video we are going to discuss about medicinal chemistry of general anesthetics. That is the very basic chapter of medicinal chemistry in Form D of final year students. Basically, these are the drugs that cause loss of consciousness. Loss of consciousness or all sensations. And absolute loss of absolute loss of sensation is termed as anesthesia. So I'm not going in detail of pharmacology of these things. If you have any question or concern, you can comment or ask me directly. So general anesthesia brings about depression of the CNS, starting with the cerebral cortex, basal ganglia, the cerebellum and the spinal cord. So this is the, you can say, a cycle of how general anesthesia works, or how the general, you can say, loss of consciousness occur. So this starts with depression of the CNS. Followed by cerebral cortex, that starts with cerebral cortex, then we have basal ganglia, and then it's followed by the cerebellum. And then spinal cord and a general loss of consciousness happen or occurs. I hope this is the basic route or flow diagram that how general anesthetics work and how the depression of the CNS occurs. It starts with this, followed by this, then this, then this, and after the spinal cord, a general loss of sensation will occur. So these general anesthetics, which produce loss of consciousness, have anesthetic property. Every drug has its own property. For general anesthetic, we have anesthetic properties known as MAC, that is minimum alveolar concentration. Just like you might have heard in antibiotics chapter that is minimum inhibitory concentration. So in anesthetics you have to consider this MAC, that is minimum alveolar concentration, that is the lowest concentration of the anesthetic, which is the lowest concentration of anesthetic in alveoli or pulmonary alveoli. Okay, so along with this minimum alveolar concentration, general anesthetics, they work on ligand gated ion channels. Ligand gated ion channel. So as you know, in pharmacology there are various type of the mechanism of drug action there are some receptors, there are some ion channels, there are some enzymes. So general anesthetics work on or what are their major target are these ligand-gated ion channels, preferably particularly that is GABA and second one is NMDA. So these two receptors are involved in the mechanism of action of general anesthetics. GABA, as you know, that is gamma amino butyric acid, and NMDA is N-methyl D-aspartate. I hope you people know about these two things. These are, and briefly if I discuss about these are inhibitory neurotransmitters. Neurotransmitters in CNS. So I hope now this makes sense, that you have to consider this MAC and then you have to consider about these GABA and NMDA receptors. I hope this is the basic concept you might have heard. Then we have stages of anesthesia. These all you have heard in physiology or pharmacology in detail, hopefully. I am just discussing about the names. You might have heard various or different names in different books. Which I am discussing over here are, there are four stages of anesthesia. The first one is analgesia. I don't know how you people are pronouncing these things, so just focus on the concept. The second is delirium. Third one is surgical anesthesia. Then fourth one is medullary paralysis. So these are the, in short, four stages of the anesthesia. Starts with analgesia. In this, the conscious sensation of the warmth, the remoteness, drifting, falling, and reduction in painful stimuli occurs. In the delirium stage, we have the loss of consciousness just starts, depression of higher center, excitement, involuntary activity, increased skeletal muscle tone, and respiration is irregular in this stage. Then we have surgical anesthesia. In this unconsciousness stage, respiration is regular, BP is maintained, and this is the stage where most of the surgical procedures are happen. Then we have medullary paralysis, that is the last and the lethal or fatal stage of anesthesia. If the concentration is become increasing, the respiratory circulatory collapse occur and the failure of respiratory or circulation takes place. I hope these things make sense. Then if we discuss about a bit of classification, okay, generally we have local anesthetics and general anesthetics, but as I said, this is discussion of the general anesthetics. So classification starts with general anesthetics, or subclassification of general anesthetics is, we have broadly two types of general anesthetics. First one is called inhalation anesthetics. Inhalation anesthetics. Second one is intravenous. So in inhalation anesthetics, we have nitrous oxide, we have halothane, we have enfluorine, we have isoflurane, we have disulfiram. In intravenous anesthetics, we have thiopental sodium, or you can say methoxetol sodium. Then we have midazolam and diazepam. Then we have ketamine. We have propofol. We have fentanyl. Morphine, etc., etc. So this is a bit of a classification, but we will discuss in detail every drug of medicinal chemistry synthesis in our next lecture. So keep subscribing us. These are the medicinal chemistry notes, as I have discussing in blogger, or my notes are there. So if you have any question, you can comment or you can ask me. Thank you.